the word was mercy. So we are talking about warm seat bath. And then with a warm seat bath, as I said, hemorrhoids is painful. Sometimes they come to the hospital complaining of pain, especially when they empty the bowel, it's very painful, right? So sometimes we as nurses, even before the surgery, we have to assess the level of pain, and then we have to administer prescribed analgesics to promote comfort and then relieve the pain. And then we also perform this technique where a lukewarm water is made and then the person sits in it to help soothing the hemorrhoids, right? It relieves pain and it makes the person comfortable. So that is the warm seat bath. Apart from that, as I said, as nurses, you should also assess. Most of the time, the doctors will diagnose the person, probably first degree hemorrhoids or second degree hemorrhoids. But nurses don't want to also do their own assessment. So as nurses, we have to also do our own assessment to know the degree of the hemorrhoids. We have to assess whether the place is sore or not, and then whether the patient is bleeding or not, right? So we have to do our own assessment and before the surgery, right? Okay, and then when the patient is taken to the theater, most of the time the patient will come, so we are going to talk about the post-op nursing interventions. Post-op nursing interventions. Post-op nursing interventions. So with the post-op nursing interventions, most of the time, the general ones, I'm not going to talk about it because we've talked about it over and over again, right? Receiving the patient, assessing the level of consciousness, checking vital signs, providing warmth, right, by covering the patient when the patient is feeling cold, and then raising your side wheels to prevent the patient from falling. Sometimes if the patient, you check the SpO2 and it necessitates that the patient is giving oxygen, you have to put on oxygen, you have to suction where necessary and all that. So these are general ones that apply to all surgeries that we talk about. You have to maintain your pH, so it means that you don't have to give anything by mouth, because bowel sounds will not have returned on the day of the surgery. So you have to keep checking the bowel sounds with your stethoscope. Sometimes you can also ask the patient whether the patient has passed platelets. And then if patient comes with any infusion or drainage tubes or catheter, you have to, as nurses, you have to monitor the all drainage tubes, and then you have to manage the patients on the intake and output chart and all. So these are the general post-op management, nursing management. But let's look at some specific nursing management for hemorrhoids. Specific nursing management for hemorrhoids. With hemorrhoids, because it's performed at the